Welcome students. Myself, Dr. Monica Khetarpal. I am Associate Professor of Physics in Government Dongar College, Bikaner. In my lecture series of Classical Mechanics, a first paper of MSc previous physics, we were dealing with Hamilton canonical equation of motion. In my previous lectures, we have derived Lagrangian equation of motion. From L approach, we have switched to H approach. The reason being is that in L approach, Qj, which is derivative of time derivative of generalized coordinate, is a dependent coordinate on Qj. So we have switched from L approach to H approach. Hamiltonian is a function of independent variables that are Qj, Pj, and T. And we have defined Hamiltonian as summation Pj Qj naught minus L. In spite of a second order n Lagrangian equations, in Hamilton canonical equation of motion, we have n number of this type of equation and n first order this equations. So we have to solve 2n first order differential equation of motion to solve our problem. Here, H is the Hamiltonian defined by this expression. Qj dot is the derivative of generalized coordinate, Pj is the generalized momenta. So in order to solve this canonical equation of motion, we must know Hamiltonian. Hamiltonian is defined by this expression. To know the Hamiltonian, we must know our Lagrangian. And from Lagrangian, we will derive Pj, that is del L by del Qj dot. So using H, we will solve these canonical equation of motion. This will be more clear through the applications. So first application, which we are going to discuss today, is that of a simple pendulum. Here, I have taken a simple pendulum in which the length of the string is L. O is the point of suspension. OA is the mean position. This pendulum is oscillating about its mean position. Let at any instant its position of the bob be A, be at B point. So we will have kinetic energy to be half mv square. Since v is omega r, and omega is theta naught, and r will is equal to L. So T is equal to half m L square theta dot square. Now, to find the Lagrangian, we have determined kinetic energy. Potential energy. Potential energy is mgh. Here, height, distance of fall in moving from B to A is equal to CA. So potential energy will be MgCA. Finding the value of CA from the diagram, as we have determined in Lagrangian equation of motion, CA will be equal to OA minus OC. OA is L and OC is L cos theta. So potential energy will be MgL 1 minus cos theta. Hence, Lagrangian of the system, we know that equal to kinetic minus potential energy. So I have obtained my Lagrangian of a simple pendulum in which I have only one generalized coordinate, and that coordinate is theta. To solve the problem using Hamiltonian approach, we must also know the generalized momenta. we know that generalized momenta is defined by Pj is equal to del L by del Qj dot. So P theta will be del L by del theta dot. Differentiating this expression with respect to theta dot, I get my P theta to be ML square theta dot. Now I have determined Lagrangian and momenta. Hence I can find my Hamiltonian. Hamiltonian, as I have already stated, is defined as summation Pj Qj dot minus L. Here I have only one coordinate. So Hamiltonian will be P theta theta dot minus L. Substituting the value of P theta and L, I get my Hamiltonian as half ML square theta dot square plus MGL 1 minus cos theta. As I have already determined that this factor is the kinetic energy. And the second factor we have determined as potential energy. So H comes out to be equal to T plus V. And we know when H equal to T plus V, then the system will be conservative in nature. So my problem of simple pendulum is conservative in nature. Now I will solve my canonical equation of motion. We know that in order to solve the canonical equation, we have to change theta dot in terms of P theta. And we have already determined P theta. So from here, we can determine theta naught in terms of P theta. From this expression, I get theta dot to be equal to P theta upon ML square. Substituting it in the Hamiltonian derived, I get Hamiltonian to be equal to P theta square upon 2ML square plus MGL 1 minus cos theta. Now I am in a position to solve my canonical equation of motion. The first equation is theta naught equal to del H by del P theta. Differential will give P theta upon ML square. And second expression, canonical equation is P theta naught equal to minus del H upon del theta. Differentiating H with respect to theta, I get minus MGL sine theta. Now I have two canonical equation of motion. Differentiating this expression, third expression, I get theta double dot equal to P theta upon ML square. So from here, I can find the value of P theta naught equal to ML square theta double dot. Putting this value of P theta dot in equation 4 and simplifying for the small value of theta, I get theta double dot plus G by L theta equal to 0. We know that this is an equation of motion of simple pendulum. As the time period of simple pendulum will be 2 pi under root L by G. We have derived the same expression when we were discussing the Lagrangian equation of motion. So Lagrangian equation of motion and another approach which we are using is the canonical equation of motion, they lead to the same solution of the problem. Another application of canonical equation is linear harmonic oscillator. This is a linear harmonic oscillator. I am taking it in one direction because it is linear, that is in x direction. Kinetic energy in x direction will be half m x dot square. Potential energy, half kx square. We have to first find the Lagrangian. L will be half mx naught square minus half kx square. To solve the canonical equation, we must know the value of H. For H, we must know momenta. Momenta px is equal to del L by del x naught Differentiating this expression, I get mx dot. So h comes out to be px x naught minus l. Putting the value, I get my Hamiltonian half mx naught square plus half kx square. As it is visible, this is the kinetic energy, T, and the second factor is potential energy. So H in this system also is equal to T plus V. So this is also an example of a conservative system. Now, we have to change X in terms of generalized momenta. We have already determined generalized momenta. So from this expression of momenta, we can find out the value of x dot. X dot will be equal to px upon m. So we can express our Hamiltonian in terms of momenta. Hamiltonian will be half m px upon m whole square, half kx square. Now, knowing the Hamiltonian, I can solve my canonical equation of motion. The first equation being px dot equal to minus del h by del x, differentiating it. First term does not contain x. From the second term, I get it to be minus kx. The second canonical equation is x dot equal to del h by del px. So differential will give me px by m. Now, from this expression, fourth expression, on differentiating it, I can get px dot is equal to mx double dot. Putting the value of px dot in third expression, I got mx double dot plus kx is equal to 0. This is the equation of motion of linear harmonic oscillator. This expression has already been determined using the Lagrangian approach. So we can solve our approach. We can solve our problem by using canonical equation of motion or Lagrangian equation of motion. The Hamiltonian canonical equation of motion. I'm summarizing them. The canonical equation of motion, which we must know, are qj dot equal to del h upon del pj and pj dot equal to minus del h upon delta qj. Here h being the Hamiltonian of the system, it is equal to summation pj qj dot minus l. I hope, students, you must have learned what I taught you today. Thank you for watching.